for more than a year, and I've been communicating with you guys and telling you na please do something about this. Not only me, but other personalities. Tao ko mismo ang gumawa ng paraan para ma-delete yun. Pero kayo wala. Wala kayo nagawa. Kayo may budget na para sa ganitong klaseng mga sitwasyon, sa ganitong klase mga problema. Wala kayong nagawa. Pero yung mga tao ko may nagawa. Pero you should not use as an excuse, Yusek Uoy, the fact na, the fact na kayo po'y naisahan, eh, medyo malaking kahiyaan po yun. Yung paggamit ng AI para sirain ang isang tao o isang kandidato, upurihin ang isang tao o isang kandidato. And definitely, these are fake news. Yung lumalabas na fake news doon o fake video or fake article about me, not only about me, about Lance Gokongwei, Enrique Razon, Jessica So, Antonita Berna, at napakarami pang personality, mga investment scam. Paulit-ulit na lang ito. And lastly, Secretary Ivan Jan Uy, next time, kapag may mga hearing at nabigyan kayo ng proper notice to attend, magpa-attend ka naman ng tao. Huwag naman yung para ka ng isnab. Para naman kayong seek, para ka naman kayong napakataas tingin nyo sa sarili ninyo. At nag-antay ng antay yung hearing, and that was a very important hearing because we were talking about the integrity of the PCA sa Oloto na marami ng tao nagka-question at walang umaten sa inyo. Ang pinatay nyo, walang kinalaman doon sa hearing. At in-snap nyo yung hearing na yon. Parang napaka-yabang nyo naman, sir. Pwede ka naman sana umaten. Sa mga hearings, umatin yung mga secretary. Bakit ikaw? Kung hindi siya maka-attend, di, why not you? Pero ikaw hindi ka umatin, parang what's so special about you, sir?
Kakagigil ang balitang ito ah. Let's watch the full story.
What do you call that? There was unauthorized access to it. We would like to reiterate, Your Honor, that the unauthorized access did not extend to the core systems of the ICT. That said, we have already improved our security mechanisms. That website po kasi is really open for uploads. Because it is where we receive field reports, especially during the times of disaster. We understand, Your Honor, that cybersecurity is a very complex matter, and that, of course, we're transparent enough and honest enough to say that if there are some systems we need to improve on, we will do so. But we reiterate, and we will be more than happy to submit to this August Chamber the report of what actually transpired. And again, let me reiterate, Your Honors, that it was an isolated system that did not, in fact, may rinan po silang scripts na hindi rin, kumbaga, they are trying to get parang improved access through an external party, parang privilege escalation ang tawag po namin dyan sa aking, and they were unsuccessful. But yes, we confirm that there was unauthorized access to it.
Pero you should not use as an excuse, Yusek Uoy, the fact na, the fact na kayo po'y naisahan, eh, medyo malaking kahiyaan po yun. Dapat no excuses. Dapat kayo ang authority pagdating cybersecurity. Dapat lahat na matanggapan nyo, umpisa nyo muna sa lahat na matanggapan nyo na hindi pwedeng ma-hack dapat. Regardless. Yun po yung point ko dito. Sa social media, rampant na ngayon yung AI. Alam nyo po yun, ano? Lalo na palapit ng eleksyon, how could you stop that? Yung paggamit ng AI para sirain ang isang tao o isang kandidato, upurihin ang isang tao o isang kandidato. And definitely, these are fake news. At nagiging rampant na to, naging talamak na. At parang totoo, para sa isang ordinaryong tao, eh parang totoo yung nakikita nilang video. At dumadami na ito, so paano po mapatigil ito?
Thank you for that question again, Your Honor. With the permission of the Secretary and Mr. Chair, right now we have a coalition with major social media platforms. We have their back-end reporting system. We agreed on a watermarking and categorization system. Once they detect that it is an AI-generated or a edited video in general, or a video that was shown without the sufficient context, pagtutulong-tulungan naming ma-detect, and they will watermark it po. They will put a label saying that this either this video is out of context or maglalagay sila ng this is possibly AI generated. So that's the first thing po na ginagawa natin. Pangalawa, Your Honor, we have a lot of information materials already telling the public how to detect this. For example, there are free websites that can be used in
the... No, you're not supposed to tell the public. You're supposed to delete those videos na para hindi na makarating sa public. Yun yung point ko. You don't tell them. You do it.
Your
kasi,
Honor...
Kasi marami nang kumakalat ng mga fake news. I myself, victim ako. Ilang beses na ako lumapit sa inyo. Yung lumalabas na fake news doon o fake video or fake article about me. Not only about me, about Lance Gokongwei, Enrique Razon, Jessica So, Anthony Taberna, at napakarami pang personality, mga investment scam. Paulit-ulit na lang ito for more than a year, and I've been communicating with you guys and telling you na please do something about this. Not only me, but other personalities. At maraming naniniwala at maraming nag-invest doon because our names were used and you guys are not doing anything. Or what have you done? Tell me, ano mga programa meron kayo para i-stop yung ganitong klaseng scam at modus? At marami nang naluloko.
Your Honor, actually, of the reports submitted to us, which we forwarded to the social media networks, I just don't have the statistics. But there are numerous number of URLs. Wala lang ako number ngayon, but it's more than 500.
You know what? You haven't done nothing for me as far as I'm concerned. Ako mismo, yung mga tao ko mismo ang tumawag sa Facebook. Tao ko mismo ang gumawa ng parang para ma-delete yun. Pero kayo wala. Wala kayong nagawa. Kayo may budget na para sa ganitong klaseng mga sitwasyon, sa ganitong klaseng mga problema. Wala kayong nagawa, pero yung mga tao ko may nagawa. Kumbaga, kanya-kanya kami, yung mga nabibiktima ng fake news, kami yung gumagawa ng paraan para mapadelete yun. Kayo wala, hanggang sat-sat lang kayo eh. Hanggang programa-programa kayo and then ask budget and then come up with this program, etc. But you're not doing anything. You're not walking the talk.
This is also an ad hoc thing because technically, we do not have a law that regulates social media platforms. Kumbaga po, sinasubmit lang din namin ito. Mas mabilis lang kasi we have a back-end system with them. But the decision to either remove it or to categorize it still remains with the social media platforms.
For example, but you should get in touch with Facebook or YouTube, whatever social media
platform that,
that is. Let them know about the problem.
Yes, sir, we do that.
Currently affecting many Filipinos, many people, especially yung mga taong mga personality na nasisira ng kanilang mga reputasyon. Let's talk about Pogo. Marami mga na-scam. Marami na bibiktima tong Pogo. Hanggang ngayon, meron pa rin. In fact, binihisan lang ng bagong pangalan itong Pogo at marami pa rin naluloko. This time, maging mga Pilipino na. Dati-dati, mga foreigners lang. Mga players sa China. Now, nagagamit yung mga Pilipino para manloko at maloko na rin. Ano pong plano nyo rito?
As early as 2022, we've been establishing strategies on how to detect the proliferation of tech scams. Slowly, we were inching our targets by providing leads to the law enforcement, considering that we are not a frontliner. But we have acquired OSINT, different technologies for geolocation of this illegal sites that are spamming our citizenry. And I believe we have been very successful in the operations on this matter because we have dismantled a big chunk of this.
Okay, if you have dismantled, sir, Yusek Ramos, bigyan nyo kami ng listahan ng mga sites na dismantle nyo o napahuli ninyo o nakasuhan po ninyo.
Yes, sir.
Ilan po?
So far, we have 16 that we have provided to law enforcement agencies.
Your effort,
yes,
meron po napasara.
Yes, sir.
Pwede kong makukita yung mga numerong yon at yung mga taong... at ano po nangyari sa kanila, aside from dismantling their operations, what I really need is, nakasuhan ba sila? Kasi madali mag-dismantle, pagkatapos patatakasin na makakatakas na yung mga Pogo operators. Ang gusto ko dapat, hindi nakatakas at nakasuhan.
That is true, Your Honor. Well, I'm proud to say that the one of the only effort wherein there is an actual conviction is a case that we operated with the Philippine National Police. It's the first conviction that was 2 months ago, a month ago, I mean. And because all of these cases are pending with the Department of Justice, but one of the cases we had in Iloilo, it was successfully, there was a successful conviction.
Alam niyo po na sinasabi nga wala ng pogo, sinasabi ito ng pagor, pero meron pa rin pong pogo, binihisan lang po ng bagong pangalan. So you better watch out for it, watch for their operations. Kasi ang sinasabi, sila ay parang BPO lamang, nagpo-process lamang ng mga taya, pero wag ka, pogo pa rin sila. So that is something that you have to focus your attention to.
That's right, Your Honor. In fact, we have developed a preemptive capability. We are preempting because it's the bare months already. There is a transition of modus operandi of these operators. In fact, when the Bureau of Immigration mentioned that 3,000 have left the country and we have over 100,000 who came in, we're still finding ways. Where are the others? And we are collaborating in these efforts with the Bureau of Immigration.
National Security Council warns of foreign interference in 2025 elections. Ito na yung nasabi kanina, hacking and misinformation, fake news. So, ano po yung programa meron kayo para mabawasan itong dangers of hacking, especially sa electoral database?
Yes, Your Honor. Actually, even before, as early as January 2023, we've been collaborating with the COMELEC as to strategies on how to address deepfakes and AI, because it's going to be a challenging effort considering that in the last Interpol conference held here in Manila, they have shared with us the best practices all over the country because there's no perfect solution. In the meantime, as far as the CICs is concerned, we were able to acquire certain tools that would allow us to tread into the virtual world, gathering all of this content. Because what COMELEC wants to count, they want to regulate the number of exposures and to find out if these are coming from directly from the candidates or not. We have specific tools for that at the moment.
Okay, and very last na, Mr. Chair. Concern talaga ako dito sa paggamit ng AI para magpakalat ng fake news. Yung mukha ng tao at pati pagbukas ng bibig, pagsalita, parang siya talaga, parang totoo talaga and all. And dumadami na eh. Do you have a program on how to stop that? Lalo na yung election?
Yes, sir.
Dami na yan. Ako, dami ko yung beses nakikita sa TikTok.
That is correct.
And then, meron yung nagsasalita. Naakala mo yung nagsasalita, talagang totoong sinasabi niya. Talagang mukha niya, pati yung pagbukas ng bibig, boses niya and all, yung pala fake news. So, how would you attack that kind of a problem that is now rampant sa ating social media?
As far as what we are doing at the present, because the lack of regulation on AI here in the country, we are adopting certain standards on identifying what is real and what is not. And in fact, we have collaborated with the academe to do a study on developing tools as well as policies on AI. I think this was recently approved with DOST and NDC. We have 6 research studies on this. Because so it has to be for future use, because the current tools that we have are what is available in the market.
And then what is this kind of tool that you're using or tools para ma-identify kung fake news ka, yung isang fake news using AI? And you're talking to experts, you say?
That's correct.
And who are these people you're talking to, sir?
Pardon, sir?
Who are these people you're talking to?
These are the academe. In the last Interpol conference, so
they're academe, but I mean, are they experts in when it comes to AI?
Programming.
Experts, yeah. So they have programming experience, and this, are they been tested? Na yeah. Talagang alam nila para mag-identify na AI. Hindi, kasi ang concern ko, sir, dumarami ng dumarami. At God forbids na baka magkakaroon ng kunting kaguluhan kung papabayaan natin to na dumadami yung AI. One of these days, meron dyan magsasalita na parang nag-iinganyo ng gumawa ng insurrection or something, and then maniniwala sila dahil parang totoo talaga yung nagbibigay ng mensahe, nag-uudyok sa mga tao na gumawa ng something or nag-expose ng something, when in fact that something is fake news. And maraming maniniwala dahil yung mukha ng tao, siya talaga yun, o mukha ng mga tao, siya, sila talaga yun, at yung boses at mukha, that is dangerous. You admit to me that, sir, right?
That's correct.
Yun, dapat mag-focus kayo dyan. Do it. Do something about it quick.
In fact, Your Honor, just a week ago, in our command conference in CICC, together with concurrence also with our partners in law enforcement, NBI and ACG, we said that after this findings, that there will be three major tools, three general tools that have to be an area of focus. One is cryptocurrency, the other one is ransomware, the other one is AI and deepfakes. These are general categories, but there are numerous tools being utilized for this purpose. All crimes are related utilizing any of these three major tools. That's why after collapsing, we are actually developing a field of expertise in this by continuous training. As early as August, the training program is ongoing for CICC personnel and our partner agencies to enhance our understanding and capability in addressing these issues.
And lastly, Secretary Ivan Jan Uy, next time, kapag may mga hearing at nabigyan kayo ng proper notice to attend, magpa-attend ka naman ng tao. Huwag naman yung para ka ng isnab. Para naman kayong napakataas tingin nyo sa sarili ninyo. At nag-antay na mag-antay yung hearing, and that was a very important hearing because we were talking about the integrity of the PCSO Lotto, na marami ng tao nagka-question at kung ano pang mga problema ang ini-issue, binabato about PCSO. At kayo lang po makakasagot doon sa DICT kung meron pa bang integridad ang Lotto, at walang umaten sa inyo, ang pinaten nyo, walang kinalaman doon sa hearing. At in-snap niyo yung hearing na yon, parang napaka-yabang nyo naman, sir.
So
hindi po siya nakaten, nasa malalamig na lugar po ba siya? Okay, iniintay namin dito eh. Sabi, parating. Hindi kami naintay hanggang sa natapos yung hearing, just dumating.
Opo. We are going to make remedial measures po. Next time po, with your invitation, we will ensure that we will have people who will be relevant to your inquiry and who can answer your questions to attend your
hearing. Kasi sharing na po yung very important yung DICT, dahil kayo po ang magsasabi kung maasahan pa ba, mapagkatiwalaan pa ba yung PCSO Lotto. Yun lang po yun eh, para ma-explain sa taong bayan based dun sa ginawa nyong assessment sa PCSO Lotto system. Eh, wala kayo, hindi kayo sumipot. So, yun na yung reason why we had that hearing. Pwede ka naman sana umaten. Sa mga hearings, umatin yung mga secretary. Mm-hmm. Bakit ikaw? Kung hindi siya maka-attend, di, why not you?
We'll put in the proper procedure.
Yung
po.
Mga ibang secretary sa iba't ibang mga department nag-a-attend eh.
Opo.
DSWD, DILG, nag-a-attend. DNR, Agriculture, yes. In-invite. Pero ikaw hindi ka umaten, parang what's so special about you, sir?